Some of the best parties in this part of the world don't actually always happen in clubs. In fact, they happen in the middle of the desert. They rely purely on word of mouth, and just getting there could be the biggest adventure.
If you go to Tel Aviv, keep your ears peeled for a desert party. They're secretive, hard to find, and often illegal. But when you get there, you're in for a treat.
The spice extends life.
Daddy Itziak and Harva Shapira are seasoned clubbers and hardcore partygoers. And today they're preparing for a rather special event.
We're going to a trance party in the desert. We bought a ticket from a friend on Sunday night. It cost us 100 shekels, about 20 pounds. We don't have a clue where the party is. We know just it's in the south and in the desert.
Reminiscent of the acid house raves that revolutionized the party scene in the UK in the late 80s, desert raves generate a special buzz.
Very exciting because it's supposed to be something big and
unique.
Yeah.
The ticket contains only one piece of information, a phone number. The call gives a meeting point where Daddy and Harva will be given the exact location of the desert party.
It's in the desert, an hour's drive from here, in a gas station. We are going to get a map there and instructions for the next step.
Part one of the mystery tour is about to begin.
In the desert, there's a special atmosphere.
It's like a snowball in the desert of people and energy that grows and grows and grows as the party starts and continues.
Harva and Didi arrive at the gas station and immediately recognize one of the party organizers. The tickets are exchanged for wristbands and a map.
Dear friend and dear people, we greet you for joining us to our magical journey. In front of us is joy, love and brotherhood.
Phase two is underway. 90 minutes later, the map leads them onto a dirt track, and before long, they've got company.
We're having a bit of a convoy behind us.
Partygoers are told to follow the green picnic signs, which will lead them to their mystery destination.
All these signs are covers for the party. Mostly it's a wedding sign or a picnic.
With signs coming thick and fast, the party must be close at hand. And 20 minutes later, as night arrives, so does our convoy.
We found it!
We found it! Yes! Hallelujah!
It looks like the party will be a big one.
Tonight is a great night. It's an amazing party. From sunset until sunrise, we're going to dance. And from sunrise until sunset, we're going to continue to dance and have fun.
And continue they do. The energy levels begin to lift as the sun comes up. And at dawn, Harva and Daddy are still going strong.
There's a big difference between desert parties and parties in clubs. In the desert, there's a special atmosphere. When the sun rises, it's amazing. You begin to see all the colors. There's something holy, almost, in the desert.
Israel is a country which loves its chants, and some of the most passionate chants lovers can be found in the most unlikely places. The Israeli army.
Every Israeli enters the army at 18. Boys join for a minimum of 3 years and girls for 21 months. At an age where young people around the world are discovering clubs and dance culture, it's perhaps no surprise that many soldiers have a passion for dance music. But what is surprising is that soldiers love trance.
I love trance music every day, every week especially. I'm going to clubs and I hear it and it's very, very nice.
Trance music makes me high.
It's the kind of music today that makes the world go round.
God is a detail.
Shai Fahi is coming to the end of his 3 year service. He works at a supply base 30 minutes from Tel Aviv.
Trance music is so popular with soldiers because right now we're in the system, as you know, it's a 3 year system. And sometimes it's a little bit stressful, sometimes it's a little bit hard. So when you finish, you know, a long, hard week in the army, so you go out on the weekend, you have a trance party.
This is the wall of flyers. Almost every party you see on this wall, I went there.
Like all non-combat soldiers in Israel, Shai works 9 to 5. He lives at home where he also makes trance music with his friend Gil.
Well, I was a soldier, I was a combat soldier. And in my time, we heard the Beatles and the Rolling Stones, that kind of music. Today, it's another generation, another music. To tell the truth, I don't know much about this music. I know that it's playing trance and ambient trance.
Tonight, Shai and Gil are heading for a trance party. But meanwhile, on the other side of town, the weekly dance music show Discotheque is kicking off on Army Radio.
Classico della trance, 96, 97, Men With No Name.
Hola!
The Discotheque is the only national show on national radio in Israel that plays electronic music.
Most of the commanders here in the army station didn't want it that much because they say trance music, it brings drugs and everything. It's really, really popular because most of the soldiers that they are in the middle of guarding, you know, when they are up in Lebanon or something like this, we have like a lot of phone calls that leaving us a message that, wow, we want to say that this 2 hours was really fabulous and we had a great time with the show and we want more of it, and it really, really was a good show.
Shai and Gil arrive at the trance party and are soon getting sweaty.
Trance music is really, really popular with soldiers because it has, you know, the beat is much higher, you know, and it's like, if you want to go and get crazy, this is the way to come and get crazy.
After a hard week in the army, this is like where soldiers like, you know, to unwind, you know, and dance and stuff like that.
Very liberating music. You know, you can get to the party and dance and liberate, get to trance.
You're looking for a break, you know, so you come here, you forget from everything, from the army, from your commanders, and party on.
Party on, boys.
The club and vibe in Tel Aviv, I think, is really, really powerful because I think the pressure they're under makes them party hard.
People want to party out there. They're full on, you know, they really want to go on until they drop.
You've got the sea, you've got the sand, you've got the sun. It's just perfect, really.
The things I've enjoyed about Tel Aviv, playing there, it boils down to the people, the atmosphere, the effort people make for the partying out there.
Fanatical clubbers. They love their music. Good on you.